Why do we age? What has to happen in order for you to slow or reverse the aging process? I believe there are well-proven, effective, what I call the seven secrets of health. And with that, I wrote a book that came out a few weeks ago called Stop Aging Now, the seven secrets to look and feel great forever. And I have a number of people who have experienced this transformation. However, there's a challenge. And with most doctors and educators and scientists and fitness people, they know that problem. And it's called New Year's resolution. And you make an affirmation. You say, this is what I'm going to do. These are the goals I want to accomplish. And then a few weeks later, after you've been going to the gym, somehow, some way, you no longer continue. You change your diet for a few weeks, and then you go to a relative's and they have some celebration. You don't just break the diet once, it's constant. You watch the Super Bowl and they have all of these advertisements and they keep telling you, eat wings, eat hot dogs, go to Taco Bell, go to Marie Callender's. And before long, your brain, which remembers and collectively absorbs everything you've ever heard or seen or experienced since the day you were born. Some people believe in the womb, and others believe even in a past life. There is a solution, and that solution means that you and I can go on a journey. And that journey, and although I think there are some people who have made this very popular in a program that I worked with and attended and perfected in the Bay Area that was pretty much based on my experiences with what's called Date with Destiny. And I discovered that I could lecture all day long and tell you all the facts of why you should do certain things, but it's really the experience. Dr. Frazier at USC, and I have my undergraduate degree in psychology and my postgraduate in lifestyle medicine, he once said that a person can believe something and be told something and affirm something, but until they actually take the action and experience it, they generally won't continue. So I created what's called the Immersion Program. The Immersion Program is basically on March 9th and 10th. It's a Saturday and Sunday. And you come at 10 in the morning, and we go into a journey of your mind. That inner journey is a very powerful one, because what happens is most of us have memories. How many here have had episodes of anger? Someone knew how to push your buttons and they could really get you upset, right? How many here have had experiences of worry and concern about the future, right? And what about sadness? Sadness is a major emotion, and usually sadness is covered up and protective by anger. You'll project anger to avoid experiencing a very hurtful situation that often brings men and women to tears, and that sadness is very deep, right? It's deep-seated. We also have other emotions of anxiety, and we have at times emotions of jealousy that tend to harm and ruin relationships. So most of us come into this world and look for solutions, but we carry recordings and baggage with us throughout our life. The beautiful thing is that when I trained with Dr. Richard Bandler, Dr. Tad James, who really trained Tony Robbins. Tony doesn't really go into much detail of the origin of what, although he'll mention it occasionally. When we would do events like Master University, I would pair up with Tony Robbins himself on stage, and he would share with me his deepest, innermost thoughts, fears, concerns, and so forth. And people would pair up in an audience of 5,000 people. I mean, it was huge events, right? And he continues now with tremendous events and gathering many, many people, but he never really shows you how to do it. So on March 9th and 10th, I'm going to give you a simple experience right now to help you to understand how powerful it is to not think about, well, you know, I'm too old, I'm too young to do this, I'm uneducated, I don't have a medical degree, I'm too poor, I'm too rich. I mean, whatever the excuse is, we make excuses, right? That's the human nature, because we don't want to face the reality that it's challenging and difficult to accomplish certain things that will take some degree of compliance and consistency. So I don't know a person in the room who's built a set of biceps or exercise by doing one repetition, right? But I do know that as a world champion, having broken two world strength endurance records, having led Team USA to the world's strongest strength endurance championships, and at that time I was the second oldest man in the whole competition, and I was the smallest man in the competition. And yet I outlifted every man in the world. There was one man within, I think, five lifts of me. I think I came just shortly behind him. But Team USA, collectively, we won that world championships. And I did it by doing two forms of exercise. How many here like to exercise? Let me see a show of hands. How many here love music? One thing, I always listen to a mix. My daughter put together this amazing mix of music. Hey, I look, I'm 70s, 80s, right? So I used to dance on American Bandstand on national television. So I'd have Michael Jackson in front of me, the Jackson 5, Steppenwolf, all these incredible groups. And I got to dance in front 10 feet away from the greatest bands in the world, right? So most of us will find something that we enjoy, like music, and we play this music ideally in our ears or so. And while we're training, and I do what's called flow training. Flow training is where you do kind of playful workout where you work continuous with no rest, but you sustain it at about 50, maybe 35 to 50% of your maximum heart rate. So it's fairly easy to carry on a conversation, but you continue through the full hour. So I might lift weights 1,000 times, literally, overhead, nonstop, with no rest. And I've built up to that. I didn't do that overnight, but eventually I built up to that. I also discovered a very unique principle in training, and that is your body has two directions in the muscles. There's eccentric, the lengthening contraction, which you're 40% stronger in letting a weight down, and you're weaker curling the weight back up. So what I do is, from the very first rep, not like most fitness people say on the 8th, 9th, or 10th rep, which is where you get all your benefit, you start immediately on the first rep putting full pressure with your partner, exerting pressure on the lengthening contraction while you fight the weight. So imagine as the weight's coming down, your partner's pushing it, and you're fighting it with all your might. And then you explode up, but after a few reps, you can't explode up because your muscles are already getting fatigued after only three reps. So the average workout only takes all eight muscle groups to complete muscular failure in 12 minutes. Do that three times a week or four. That's less than an hour of training in the gym, and you get a fabulous outcome. World class, world strength, world power, and you fight muscle atrophy. Atrophy, sarcopenia, as we age, we lose muscle density. It's stated, you know, you get 60, 70, 80, the muscles don't absorb or build muscle. So now that's the next part of it. You have to understand balancing your hormones. How many have had a doctor that's done appropriate testing with saliva measuring 11 different hormones, including cortisol, DHA, pregnenolone? How many have done a 24-hour urine test that collects the urine, and we measure 38 different hormone metabolites, and then blood tests that measure all the other binding proteins and various hormone relationships. Does anyone have a doctor that's done that? Of course not. We do this on all of our clients. For as little as $99, you can measure 11 hormones with a little test kit. At our booth, we have you spit into a little tube. You fill it all up at night, the nighttime test. And in the morning when you wake up, you fill out that last one before you brush your teeth. We send it off to Florida. There's a self-mailer. We get the results back and we go over it. That's the beginning point. It's that simple. Now, if you don't have the money to invest in the blood work and the 24-hour urine test, that's okay. We at least have a starting point. Then we do a simple questionnaire. And at my booth, I have a QR code, and you just scan it and you answer. Actually, you can even write this down, which is use DelgadoProtocol.com/apply, and you apply to enter into the program on March 9th and 10th. And you also then do DelgadoProtocol.com/evaluation. That takes you about 15 minutes to fill out all the questions. Most of those questions will detect underlying hormonal deficiencies. And I'm going to be quite fair to other doctors in the world because I've treated many of them. I've tested their blood under a microscope. I've probably looked at more people's blood in the history of mankind, having done it for over 45 years. And during that time, I've also noticed that certain people are strong in certain areas, but you're only as strong as your weakest link. So let's say you've already mastered, you've got fitness down, you've got your diet dialed in pretty good, and we look under the microscope, yeah, that looks pretty good. Let's say maybe you have detoxification and you're getting in the infrared spa, you're taking in 100 grams of fiber a day. How many here know you're taking in at least 100 grams of fiber a day and have at least 4 or 5 bowel movements a day? No one, right? None of you. So if you're weak in any of these things I've mentioned so far, and then you have an injury and the doctor does this, he goes and says, let's do surgery, let's do a knee surgery, let's do a shoulder. Do you know how big a business that is? And do you know what the outcome, because I worked in physical therapy, I see the outcome of these surgeries. Do you know that your body is based on a spring system? When they do surgery, they're doing it based on a lever system. A lever system is just kind of left and right, and it's like pushing up and down, up and down. But a spring system means that when you walk, you literally, we say spring in your step when you're younger and you're fit and all that, and it's the force of this. The spring has this full power of a spring, right? When they do surgery, you've lost it. That shoulder, that hip, that knee will no longer follow through on a spring system. You'll never be the same. You're better off if you don't do, and hear me clearly, the doctor will say, oh, you have bone rubbing on bone. There's nothing we can do for you. And yet, Dr. Peter Fields over in Santa Monica will tell you, if you did stem cells, and he's a marathon runner, and he talks about it's impossible to have bone rubbing on bone if you walk and the bones wouldn't allow you to even move a moment. So if you're moving, if you're able to walk, or maybe you're walking with pain, there's still cartilage. Guess what? We've discovered over 100 MRIs when we inject stem cells of a particular nature. You don't have to go to Panama like some people say and spend $60,000. It's about $4,000 for a vial. And we inject these vials into your body, and those stem cells know where your damage is. Now, some of the better orthopedics will actually do little drill plugs in the areas where the cartilage is little or none. And so the body views that as injury and draws a whole bunch of stem cells. When you're born, you produce billions of stem cells, billions with a B. When you're your age, how many here are past the age of 40? May I see a show of hands? How about past the age of 50, 60? Anyone past 70, past 80? Okay. When you get to that, you barely produce 10,000 stem cells, not a billion. Maybe you get to a point where you produce a thousand stem cells. Your body can't heal itself any longer. So we can do this based on biological healing in nature. We just can't talk about we do stem cells because we have to talk about regenerative medicine, because just like certain words I never use, like when they do this to you, and I've never had one in my whole life, and my grandparents knew this was wrong to not have to shut down the whole world and do craziness that the world is going through because Big Pharma wants to take your money. And once they prove to you that you develop more diseases after those injections of artificial substances that have nothing to do, have never been in your body, why in the F, excuse me, are you using these things? Because Hitler said it best. If you repeat a lie often enough on all of the media and you tell everyone over and over again, wear a mask, do this, I can't use that word, wear this, do this, and bend over and do this, and why don't you just bend over and take it? I mean, if you like that, that's different. I'm sorry, okay, I don't know. I'm in, LA, what can I say? Listen, having and making love with a significant other, consenting adult, 3 times a week or more will prove more longevity than if you have intimacy once a week with yourself. Now, I'm gonna tell you flat out, there's a lot of evidence that that energy between two people is shared at a very heightened level, but there's a lie in the bedroom. And I wrote about that in my book, Mastering Love, Sex, and Intimacy. And I said this very clearly, that female physiology is such, and you've heard of Masters and Johnson or Kinsey, famous sex researchers. If not, they took 4 gynecologists, They laid women down. They probed with probes to find the intimacy, the sensitive areas. They found zero pleasure nerve endings inside the vagina. Porn has done us a disservice because they show these guys pounding around on ladies and they're all acting like, what is it, Harry Met Sally. They're gushing like it's like the greatest experience of their life and they're getting zero pleasure. Women will never, let me tell you this clearly. I've coached couples that have been together for 20 years. My wife first told me after 5 years, you're a lousy lover. 5 years it took you to tell me? Well, I read every book and books written by men. And I'm like, oh, okay. So now I started reading books by women, for women who, you know, how do you, it was completely different. It was a game changer. So I wrote a book and another book came out right before mine called She Comes First. If you don't understand what that means, you better read his book and you better read my book, Mastery, Love, Sex, Intimacy. It'll change the whole game of your relationship. It'll be completely different. Women have a 20-minute delay and figure about an hour bell curve before some of them will come within the first 20 minutes, others at the 30-minute point, others at the hour. But if it's stimulation properly and directly and not so direct as you imagine, guys, you guys like it like this, real hard and strong. Girls don't like it that way. That lie in the bedroom has caused 75% divorce rate. Well, you'll say, oh, wait a minute, Nick. Laura Langmire, the millionaire mix, oh, most of it is divorce out of financial issues. Well, let me tell you, if someone comes home and they're expecting to make love and the guy's the only one that's enjoying that session and the woman walks away and uses her vibrator after you leave, let me tell you, there's a problem. So you have to solve these seven principles and secrets of health. And when you do, your life will change. And so on March 9th and 10th, we're going to do a deep dive immersion on your nutrition. You can lie to other people, but I remember Dr. Brooke Goldner said she put up a lockbox that she didn't know the code to the family refrigerator because she kept looking in the refrigerator and eating things she shouldn't eat. I had that happen in my household when my son-in-law moved in, a gourmet chef, and he was offering me foods to eat. And I finally just got my own refrigerator upstairs, and I said, don't show me that food. I don't want to eat it. Don't allow it. I have a choice, and you have a choice too. There's two things that pass your lips, either a kiss that you choose or the food that you choose to eat. No commercial is going to force you to eat the things you shouldn't eat. And yeah, for about a month and a half, you're going to Jones, I guess is that a normal term, and you're going to have issues with a food addiction that's stronger than cocaine. But once you let go of those sugars and oils and processed foods, and you start eating whole plant natural foods, and you eat something that's so tasty and delicious, fruits, vegetables, Asian food, Thai food, Mexican food, Spanish food, I've come up with all the recipes. I love traveling around the world and find recipes and sharing with people. I have two cookbooks. This is the actual cookbook that Tony Robbins used, the 9-day program, and they produce the foods at the Hilton Hotel in Hawaii. And buffet style, they ate the actual recipes from my book, and in 9 days, they had a 30 to 40% drop in cholesterol and triglycerides. Blood pressure came down to normal in 9 days. There's no drug on the planet that will do that. And the truth is that when you imagine people with Alzheimer's, and I've helped 3 patients who had stage 4 Alzheimer's, couldn't even function, drooling, couldn't even understand or recognize who you were, 2 of which were my relatives. So I knew exactly what was going on, but they were drugged up on meds that I don't know a patient past the age of 60 or 70 that isn't drugged up on 10 or 20 medications. And so we work with you. We optimize your hormones, we get to the cause of the problems, we select, detoxify, we increase your energy, your well-being, your fitness level, your happiness and love and connection. And by the end, if you are or you have a senior that's so demented, I never forget Lee Shackley. You've heard of Amway, Lee Shackley's wife. She was in stage 4 dementia. The doctor said, we can't help her. You can't do anything for her diet or hormones or anything. And I said, listen, Lee, the doctor won't allow me to do anything to help this patient because they're saying she won't bother to eat the food because she won't like it. Well, she had stage 4. She's drooling. She doesn't know what she's eating. And she needs these medications or she'll die. Well, she's half dead already, for Christ's sake. She can't recognize who you are. So he said, fire the doctor, bring in your own. I did. Dr. Goslin from LA, we brought him in, works up at Brett with me, and we took her off all the meds judiciously. We put her on a whole plant-based oil-free sugar diet. We got her standing up outdoors in the sun on a whole body vibration plate. We went through and rubbed hormone creams on her. We optimized her, and within 6 weeks, she went to Newport Beach Fashion Island, greeted every store owner driven up by her limo, recalled every conversation a lady that was told stage 4, nothing could be done for her. So you tell me, the brain is the most important thing you have, and if you lose your function, you're screwed big time, and not in a good way screwed. Love you all. See you at the booth 153. Come get your microscope test done. Look at the inner universe, and you're going to see things you've never imagined, because we're going to go a deep dive in your brain, and you can just write down foreveryoungevent.com, and you can register. There's room, only 25 seats at my executive home in Costa Mesa. Dr. Jeffrey Benton will be there. There's going to be celebrities there speaking and talking, and we're showing you food demonstrations, herbs, supplements, and everything, and we'll have our microscope there. Love you all.